And thereby destroy the principalities and powers of darkness, Do thou thyself, O Master, lover of mankind, accept also from us sinners these prayers of thanksgiving and entreaty, and deliver us from every destructive and dark transgression, and from all enemies, both visible and invisible, that seek to do us evil. Nail down our flesh with the fear of thee, and blind our hearts into words of thoughts and evil, but pierce our souls with longing for thee, so that ever looking to thee and being guided by thy light, as we behold thee in the unapproachable and everlasting life, we may set up unceasing praise and thanksgiving unto thee, the unoriginate Father, who thy only begotten Son, who thine all holy and good life creating Spirit, now and ever unto thee, it is of ages on thy own.
Start together. O God, cleanse the sinners and have mercy on us. O God, cleanse the sinners and have mercy on us. O God, cleanse the sinners and have mercy on us. O heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present, hold us all things, treasure good things in the world of life, come and dwell in us, acquaint us of all impurity, and save our souls. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill among men. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise.
It is time for the Lord to act. Bless Master.
Blessed is our God, all the ways of heaven and to the ages of ages.
Pray for us.
May the Lord direct your steps.
Remember us.
May the Lord govern with you in his kingdom, all the ways of heaven and to the ages of ages.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
In peace, and let us pray to the Lord. Above and for the salvation of our souls, and let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, and for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, and let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy temple, and for them that with faith, reverence, and the fear of God today we rend, let us pray to the Lord. Lord and Father Kirill, the most holy Patriarch of Moscow and all Russia, and for our Lord, the very most Reverend Metropolitan Hilarion, for his Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, for the Venerable Priesthood, the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
this land, its authorities and armed forces, and for the God-preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
this city, for every city and country, and for the faithful who dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For a seasonable weather, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by sea, land, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the imprisoned, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
that we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, and let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Amen.
Thank you. Amen.
grace and of glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
O Lord, save the pious, and hearken unto us.
Temperance. Against such there is no law. passions and love. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vainglory, provoking one another, envying one another. Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fall, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bearing one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ.
Peace be unto thee that readeth.
And thy spirit.
Wisdom. Evangelist Luke.
May God, through the intercessions of the holy, glorious, all-praised Apostle and Evangelist Luke, give speech with great power unto thee that bringest the good tidings, unto the fulfillment of the gospel of his beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Wisdom aright, let us hear the holy gospel.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Let us attend.
At that time Jesus entered into a certain village. There met with him 10 lepers, which stood afar off. And they lifted up their voices and said, Jesus, Master, have mercy on us. And when he saw them, he said unto them, Go show yourselves unto the priest. And it came to pass that as they went, they were cleansed. And one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, and with a loud voice glorified God, and fell down his face at his feet, giving him thanks. And he was a Samaritan. And Jesus answering said, Were there not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9? There are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger. And he said unto him, Arise, go thy way, thy faith hath made thee whole. The Lord said, All things are delivered unto me of my Father. And no man knoweth the Son but the Father, neither knoweth any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomsoever the Son will reveal him. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden light.
Peace be unto thee that bringest the good tidings.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us all say with our whole soul and with our whole mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, almighty. Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great mercy. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again, we pray for our great Lord and Father, the most holy Patriarch Kirill, and for our Lord and the very most Reverend Metropolitan Hilarion, first Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, and for all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for this land, its authorities and armed forces, and for all who with faith and piety dwell therein, and for the God-preserved Russian land and its Orthodox people, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray to the Lord our God that he may deliver his people from enemies, visible and invisible, and confirm in us oneness of mind, brotherly love, and piety. Again, we pray for our brethren, the priests, monks, and all our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever-memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, for pious kings and right-believing queens, and for the founders of this holy temple, and for all our fathers and brethren, gone to the rest before us, and the Orthodox here and everywhere laid to rest.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
O physician of souls and bodies, with compunction and broken hearts we fall down before thee, and groaning we cry unto thee, heal the sicknesses, heal the passions of the soul and body of thy servants, the Archpriest Michael, the Protodeacon Paul, the Monk Joseph, Ksenia, Maria, Catherine, Anastasia, Holm, Kosara, Sophia, Holm, Nina, Mary, Elena, Natalia, Andrew, Lydia, Michael, Harry, Philip, Mariana, Adrian, Dimitri, Christopher, Vladimir, Jubinza, Constantine, and Anna, and pardon them, for thou art kind-hearted, all their transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, and quickly raise them up again from the beds of sickness. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again, we pray for those who are being persecuted for the faith, especially the Christian faithful of Iran, Syria, Palestine, Egypt, and across the Middle East, that the Lord God will send down upon them every spiritual weapon to endure their tribulations, and that he will grant that peace which passes all understanding upon the region and throughout the whole world as a foretaste of his heavenly kingdom.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Thou hast given us thy commandments to love thee, our God, and our neighbor. Make hatred, hostility, offense, wrath, and the spilling of blood to cease, that true charity might reign in the hearts of the people of the Ukrainian land. We pray thee, O our Savior, hearken and have mercy. Again, we pray for them that bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for them that minister and them that chant, and for all the people here present who wait thy great and abundant mercy.
Merciful God art thou, and the lover of mankind, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, look down with thy merciful eye upon the sorrow and greatly painful cry of thy children abiding in the Ukrainian and Middle Eastern lands. Deliver thy people from civil strife. Make to cease the spilling of blood and turn back the misfortune set against them. Lead unto sanctuary those bereft of shelter. Feed the hungry, comfort those who weep, and unite the divided. Leave not thine own flock who abide in sorrows on account of their kinsmen to diminish, but rather, as thou art benevolent, give speedy reconciliation. Soften the hearts of the unmerciful and convert them to the knowledge of thee. Grant peace to thy church and to her children, that with one heart and one mouth we may glorify thee, our Lord and Savior, unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Pray, catechumens, to the Lord. Be faithful for the catechumens. Let us pray that the Lord will have mercy on them, that he will catechize them with the word of truth, that he will reveal unto them the gospel of righteousness, that he will unite them to his holy Catholic and apostolic church. Save them, have mercy on them, help them, and keep them, O God, by thy grace. Ye catechumens, bow your heads to the Lord.
That they also with us may glorify thy most honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
As many as our catechumens depart, as many as our catechumens depart,
have mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom.
For unto thee is due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Churches of God and the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy temple and remember with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter herein, let us pray to the Lord. That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
That always being guarded under thy dominion, we may send up glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Represent the chair of the chant of Christ when they give unto the life creating Trinity of Hallelujah, Son, Holy Savior. We may receive the key of all the purpose of the power and joy of the Holy Spirit. Also mystically represent the chair of the chant of Christ when they give unto the life creating Trinity of Hallelujah, Son, Holy Savior. Present the cherubim and chant the thrice holy hymn unto the life creating Trinity now lay aside all earthly care.
We may receive the kingdom of all the world come with the use of the upon and try.
great Lord and Father Kirill, the most holy patriarch of Moscow and of Russia, Archimandrite of the Holy Trinity, St. Sergius Mavra, and our Lord and the very most Reverend Hilarion, Metropolitan of Eastern America, New York, First Hierarch of the Russian Church abroad, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Expand its authorities and armed forces in the Orthodox faithful that dwell herein. The God preserved Russian land and her Orthodox faithful, both in the homeland and in the diaspora, and the Orthodox faithful of every land. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
For the clergy, the monastics, for those who are persecuted and suffer the Orthodox faith, for the founders and benefactors, and for the brothers and sisters of the Holy Temple, may the Lord God remember for this heavenly kingdom now and ever to the ages of ages.
For the aged, the infirm, those who are bedridden, those who are in prison, those who are homeless, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
You and all Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
And your sacred diaconess, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom,
always, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Let us ask of the Lord. An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord. Things good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. Of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. Our Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Calling to remembrance our most holy, most pure, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Lord, in the compassion of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy and good and uncreating Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
Holy Son and Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence, and indivisible.
The doors in wisdom let us attend. Attend that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us lift up our hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord. Triumphal hymn, shouting, crying aloud, and singing.
Of the world.
This is my body which is broken for you for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins.
Amen.
Sitting at the right hand, the second and glorious coming again.
Thine own, of thine own, we offer unto thee in behalf of all and for safety, honor, health, and length of days, rightly dividing the word of thy truth. Of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you.
Having called
remembrance of all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. And our God, the lover of mankind, having accepted them upon his holy and most heavenly and noetic altar as an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Lord, have mercy. That we may be delivered from all tribulation, wrath, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Lord, have mercy. That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. Grant it, O Lord. An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Grant it, O Lord. Our sins and offenses, let us ask of the Lord. Thanks, God, profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. Our Christian ending of our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
build us.
Lord, have mercy on us, and save us, O Lord, and exalt him above. all the sins of the world.
With the fear of God and with faith and love, draw
dear brothers and sisters, let us pray together.
I believe, O Lord, and I confess that thou art truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who camest into the world to save sinners, of whom I am chief. Moreover, I believe that this is truly thy most pure body, this is truly thine own precious blood. Wherefore, I pray thee, have mercy on me and forgive me my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, in knowledge and in ignorance, and vouchsafe me to partake without condemnation of thy most pure mysteries unto the remission of my sins and life everlasting. Amen. Of thy mystical supper, O Son of God, receive me today as a communicant, for I will not speak of the mystery to thine enemies, nor will I give thee a kiss as did Judas, but like the thief do I confess thee, and remember me, O Lord, in thy kingdom. Let not the communion of thy most pure mysteries be unto me for judgment or condemnation, O Lord, but unto the healing of soul and body. Amen.
Save, O God, thy people, and bless thine inheritance.
Deacon Patrick, I'm like you, my father, father.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Let our mouth be filled with thy praise, O Lord, that we may hear thy glory. For thou hast saved us, O Lord,
and thou hast defined
the mortal as thy creating mysteries. Heed us in thy
partaken of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, and life-giving, fearful mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Having asked that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commit ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God.
Our sanctification, and unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us depart in peace. Sanctify them that put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify them that love the beauty of thy house, and that glorify them by thy divine power. And forsake us not that hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, and to all thy people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and cometh down from thee, the Father of light. And unto thee do we send up glory at thanksgiving and worship. To the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, who is forbidden forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, who is forbidden forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, who is forbidden forevermore.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now, dear brothers and sisters, it's the custom to preach on the gospel reading for the day, but I think perhaps again, as we did a few weeks ago, we might want to dwell for a few minutes on today's two epistle readings, because they speak to the state of our life in Christ. The first of these two epistles that we heard today of St. Paul is one of the so-called epistles of the prison epistles. It was written to the community at Ephesus. And we begin with Paul's exhortation to the faithful of Ephesus to be children of the light. But what we don't see in the preceding seven verses are what he has to say about the other side of that equation, what it means to walk in darkness. This is very much a chapter that contrasts being in Christ, which is the focus of today's reading, and being out of Christ, being subject to bondage, subject to the prince of this world. But Christ reminds us that now ye are light in the Lord, and that as such ye are to walk as children of the light. And then he goes on to speak about the fruits of light. And he claims for his people, he writes for his people, that the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness and righteousness and truth,
proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. And have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but rather reprove them. I'd like to speak for a moment about this particular verse, because I think for many of us, especially in this culture and in this climate, we are tempted to live our life of faith in secret, keeping it hidden, doing works of private virtue. But there is no such thing. What St. Paul is speaking about when he speaks of the fruits of the Spirit is the manifestation of the grace of the Holy Spirit. And this is something that by its very nature is outward focused. It bears fruit within us, yes, but that fruit is then meant to be directed outward to all of creation. The Greek lays things out much more explicitly than we have in English translation. But in calling us, in calling the Ephesians of his day to reprove the works of darkness, he is exhorting the faithful to wage war on the prince of this world. Now, not all of us are called to wage that war in the same way or with the same weapons, but nonetheless, we are all called upon to speak out against darkness when we encounter it, to speak in favor of the light, or at the very least, to live our lives in a way that is consonant with what God has given us. And perhaps this is what we are called to, brothers and sisters, to not be ashamed of our faith, to not be afraid to live our faith openly, not in a way that flaunts it to other people, but in a way that proclaims our fidelity to Christ. St. Paul goes on to say, "Wherefore he saith, Awake, thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee light." The commentators on this verse remind us of the sacrament of holy baptism, because baptism, if we think about it, dear brothers and sisters, is also a form, a spiritual recognition of death and rebirth into life. We are taught that when we go into the baptismal waters, we die to our old selves. And we may be tempted to think that this is symbolic only, but it is not. There is something real and palpable that occurs when we go into the font and come back out. And it is this to which St. Paul is alluding here. Awake, thou that sleepest, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give thee life. It is only by sleeping, by descending into death, and then rising from that sleep, that spiritual sleep, that spiritual slumber, that Christ can give us light, that he can enliven us. St. Paul then goes on to say, "See then that ye walk circumspectly in the Lord." Some translations render this, "walk strictly." And we may be tempted to think of it in that way, but dear brothers and sisters, I would caution you in that respect. Orthodoxy is a faith that lends itself to extremes, either extreme laxness on the one hand or extreme strictness on the other. And St. Paul is not speaking of either of these here. He is saying to walk with vigilance, to walk with sobriety, to walk with watchfulness. We hear the word nepsis. Nepsis, do we think about what that word means when we encounter it? To be watchful, to be ever vigilant, to be careful to guard that which God has given us. Not as fools, but as wise. And he says that in so doing, when we are vigilant, we redeem the very time. Because the days in which he was writing, as the days in which we find ourselves today, were days characterized by great evil and excess. St. Paul is saying, as Christ demonstrated in his life to be countercultural, we are called upon to be in the world, but not of it. We are called upon to be something other and different and holier. And St. Paul is reminding the faithful of this very thing. It's interesting that in the prison epistle, St. Paul speaks to communities that he had never met. But nonetheless, he speaks with great insight. And he speaks words that are not true just for these communities, but that are universally true as well. We next hear the epistle from Galatians. And this particular epistle reading we hear every time there is a venerable saint. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, and temperance. Against such there is no law. These are the outpourings of the light of which St. Paul wrote in his epistle to the Ephesians. For if we walk in light, if we strive to acquire and to maintain Christ in ourselves, we cannot help but be fertile ground for that grace of the Holy Spirit, which then works in us to generate all of the virtues that St. Paul lays out in his epistle to the Galatians. And here again, we have reference to death. And they that are Christ's have crucified the flesh with the affections and the lusts. We are called upon to put our lusts, our affections, our passions, we are called upon to crucify them. And St. Paul, in the commentaries, is said to speak of an interior crucifixion. This is the battle we wage within ourselves, to deny the vices and to acquire the virtues. And here again, we have reference to walking in the Spirit. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. And here again, the Greek is remarkable, because the image that comes across in the Greek is of marching in formation, of walking in lockstep with one another as an army that is walking to a common purpose, but also as a community that is marching and following its leader, its head, Christ. That's not as obvious to us when we read the English, but this is speaking very strongly to us, to march to the tune, to march to the rhythm, to the cadence of He who has given us His commandments. This is an allusion to doing what the Church has given us to do, because in so doing, we become one body that works together to accomplish the will of its head, our Lord and God and Savior Jesus Christ. He goes on to warn against succumbing to the passions, but he also talks about how to interact with one who has fallen. And perhaps this, too, is something that we should reflect on, dear brothers and sisters. We live in an age where it's all too easy to point the finger, to call to mind one another's shortcomings, to be critical, to bear witness to the worst in human nature. And St. Paul is exhorting us to do exactly the opposite. If we need to correct a fault, to do so, but to be spiritual when we do that, to restore them in meekness and gentleness and kindness and love, and not to do so publicly. To reprove somebody publicly is the response of last resort. When all else has failed, we may have recourse to the church or to the square. But in anything before that, we are called upon out of a spirit of love to seek the conversion, the restoration, and the salvation of our brother and sister. Dear brothers and sisters, the fasts are times of preparation for us. They are times of anticipation. They are times of pondering upon the great mystery of the feast to which they are tied, to the pearl on the string of salvation which God has given us through His Church. We are called upon in all times, in all seasons, to give alms, to do acts of kindness for one another. And St. Paul is speaking to this here as well, when he enumerates the virtues, when he ties them back to divine love. He reminds us also in the scriptures, in the epistles, that the outgrowth of those virtues is seeing to the needs of our brothers and sisters, because in so doing we see to the commandment of our Lord Himself. May God grant us, as we enjoy this season, and may God grant us as we prepare to greet His glorious nativity, may He grant us to seek out Christ not only in the manger, as the West says, but may He exhort us to find the Christ in our neighbor who is ailing, or who is homeless, or who is without money or food or drink. May He grant us to give of our abundance so that they might be full. May He grant us to share with others the joy of this season. All too often we think of fasts as times of deprivation. They are not. They are times that if we follow the fast with faith and according to proper measure, they are times of great enrichment for us. They are times when God bestows His grace beyond measure upon us. May we see the fast in this light, in the most positive light. Everything is given to us for our salvation, even the times when we deny ourselves. Let us deny
our flesh in this season, that we might deny the lusts that St. Paul writes about. And in so doing, may we, in some small measure, advance one step further on our journey to the heavenly kingdom. Amen. The blessing of the Lord be upon you through his grace and love for mankind, always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, hope in our God. Glory to thee. True God, who rose from the dead through the intercessions of his most pure mother, of the holy, glorious, and all praised apostles, of the holy prophet, forerunner, and baptist of the Lord John, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of the Venerable Sabbas the Sanctified, of St. Urius, Archbishop of Kazan, of the martyr Anastasius, of the Venerable Cardian and his son, St. Zechariah of Egypt, of St. Nicetius, the Bishop of Trier, of the Venerable Justinian, Hermit of Wales, of St. Cosmas of Atipedi, and the monks of Cardius Maldathos, martyred by the Latins, of the Venerable Nectarius of Bitol, and his elder St. Philotheus of Cardius Skeet Maldathos, of the martyr Diogenes, the martyr of Erchius, St. Nonus the monk, St. Gratus the monk, the new higher martyrs Elias the priest and Gennadius, of St. Sergius the confessor and priest, of our father among the saints, John Archbishop of Shanghai and San Francisco the wonder worker, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Donna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and the lover of mankind. Again, we have a number of announcements as we near the St. Herman's Conference, which kicks off at the end of the week. First on the list, though, tonight we will serve vigil on the occasion of the Feast of St. Nicholas at 6:30 p.m., followed tomorrow morning at 6:40 a.m. by Hours in Divine Liturgy. This coming Tuesday, we will have Slavonic Choir rehearsal at 7 p.m., and this coming Thursday, December the 22nd, at 7 p.m. in the Parish Library, the work will continue with Natasha Mulligan and those who are assisting her in cataloging books. And thank you to all who have come out on behalf of Natasha and the parish, because you all have done a great labor and things are looking very good, thanks to God. Starting next Friday, December 23rd, and running through Tuesday, December 27th, our parish will be hosting the 37th annual St. Herman of Alaska Youth Conference, as you've seen in the announcements and the emails that have come out in prior weeks. While many of the activities will be held at the Hyatt Hotel in Arlington, others will be conducted here within the parish and in the church, including the divine services and three meals. We are expecting up to 200 participants in the conference from throughout our Eastern American Diocese and Canada as well. As such, this is a number that is significantly larger than in prior years, and as a result of that, the local conference committee urgently needs help from parishioners to prepare the meals, with cleaning, and in general, to keep things in good order on the property throughout the length of the conference. Sign-up genius has been put together to streamline the volunteer sign-up process and was emailed yesterday to all on our listserv. If you have any questions or you don't know that address, please reach out to one of us. We'll be happy to point you to somebody who can get you online so that you can register to help. While most conference attendees are getting rides or are driving into town, a small number are flying into the airports around the region throughout the day on Friday and then departing again on Tuesday, December the 27th. Our conference organizers are arranging rides for them to the hotel as well. Oh, thank you, Matushka. There is also a sign-up sheet at the candle stand if you would like to sign up in person while you are here. Back to the coordinating the rides for the conference, if you have a car, and of course larger vehicles are better for this, and if you have some free time on the transportation days, please contact Andrei Maravyov, and we'll be happy to share his email address or point him out to you while you're here to see if there are particular pickups that you'd be able to help with. If we are able to get enough volunteers, this will of course relieve some of the burden on the youth organizers who have had their hands full, and it will allow them to spend Friday helping the visitors to settle in and welcome them to DC as they come. It would be good in that vein if some of the parents of the participants could help. So if your children are participating in the conference and you would like to then also help out with your own labors, that would be a wonderful thing if you're able to do so. Our organizers are also coordinating the help of responsible adults for nighttime curfew of our youngsters. This is always a challenge, not because our youngsters are not God-fearing, but because they are youngsters. And so if you are able to help out with the curfew, please volunteer to do so. That also will be a godly work, although albeit a thankless one, possibly. For our late owls, think after midnight. If you have any late evenings or late nights free for December 23rd through December 26th, again, please contact Andrei at the email or see him while you are in the parish together. The service schedule follows as well next Saturday, December 24th. Because of the conference, we will have but one vigil beginning at 5 p.m. and one divine liturgy the following morning, Sunday morning at 8:30 a.m. This is a totally non-standard time, so make note of that, 8:30. Since we will have precious little space to seat our many guests at the three meals here at the parish for this Sunday only, we kindly ask our parishioners to refrain from the usual Sunday meal to make room for our guests at the conference. We understand that this is an opportunity for fellowship, and we will return to our regular feeding schedule the next Sunday, but we ask you that for this Sunday you do relinquish your seat for one weekend so that our attendees might have a place to sit and engage in conversation. We ask for your understanding, your prayers, and we offer our thanks in return. Your help is much appreciated. As always, we have a significantly better than expected turnout, as I mentioned earlier, and our hope is that if we can all work together, this will be a memorable conference, as the last one that was hosted in DC 20 years ago was a memorable conference as well. For those who are interested in helping with food preparation, I was asked to point out our parishioner Lisa Pulley, who is standing at the front of the church and who many of you know. So please, if you're able to help with food prep, please do see Lisa. She would be, I'm sure, greatly appreciative of any and all takers. Once again, for those who have received communion, please do remain in church for the reading of the post-communion prayers. We will have a meal following next door. The last announcement that I almost forgot is one that I forgot to write down, but we will be celebrating the Nativity of Christ with an English language woka on January the 15th. We are in the process of organizing that. What we have lined up at the moment is the singing of hymns and carols, which our choir director is in the process of organizing. We are hopeful that our parishioner, Sarah Davies, might step forward and organize the other activities or name somebody else in her stead if she's unable to do it herself. But we would like to have a short meeting next door to talk through some of the activities that we might do and to come up with a tentative schedule. So if you have time to join us in the parish hall for that discussion, that would be appreciated also. And in that note, I would look out for an email. For those who are unable to stay, we'll also send an email summarizing the outcome of that meeting as well. Once again, thank you for your attention. I know this was a lengthy set of announcements, but may God bless your week as well.
Creating a spiritual well-being and sanctification. of our souls and bodies. Grant that these may be appropriate for the healing of both soul and body, for the averting of everything possible, the enlightenment of the eyes of my heart, for the peace of the heart and of my soul, for faith and shame, for love and fame, for the fullness of wisdom, for the keeping of thy commandments, for an increase of thy divine grace, for the attainment of thy kingdom, that be preserved by them in thy holiness. And may I be remembered in thy grace always, and no longer live for myself, but for the ever master benefactor, and that for my happy part of this life, the hope of life eternal, I may attain the sacrifice of the rest of the Son, and the living, the soul unceasing, and may delight in the rest of them, the holy and the beauty of thy conscience, for thou art the true desire, and the utmost gladness of them that love thee, O Christ our God, and all creation, thus give thee, unto the ages, amen. O Master Christ our God, King of the ages, creator of all things, I thank thee for all the goodness of thou hast put upon me, and for the faith of thy most pure and great mysteries. I pray thee, therefore, good one and lover of mankind, that he who has fallen in the shadow of thy wings, may grant me even of my last breath, for the worthy of your conscience, for the holy and fearful permission of the Son of God, for thou art bread of life, the source of holiness, the giver of good things, and unto thee be sent of glory together with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and at the age of ages. Amen. O thou who will be glad to give me thy precious food, that more fire that doth consume me unworthy, let me not be scorched, O my Creator, but rather as in thou hast my members, with all my joints, my veins, my heart, burn up the thorns of all my sins, purify my soul, sanctify my thoughts, strengthen my substance together with my bones, enlighten my physical senses, my downfall will be with the fear of thee, ever protect, preserve, and keep me from every soul-crushing deed and word, purify, cleanse, and adore me, give me understanding and love in me, show me to the glory of wisdom by spirit alone, and no longer have a fish of sin, that for me has been abode, through the entry of communion, every evil doer, every passion made free as from fire, as it is destined I offer unto thee all the saints, the commandments of the bodily toast, thy forerunner, the wise apostles, and thy son, the foster mother, which entreaties be thou accept, O my compassionate Christ, and make us servant a child of life, for thou alone art our king. Good one, and radiant, and the radiance of our souls, and the command unto thee, as God and Master, we also employ as we meet every day. O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, may thy holy blood be unto me for life eternal, my precious blood for the remission of sins, and may the Eucharist be unto me for joy, health, and gladness, and if thy breath that becoming God save me, a sinner, to stand at the right hand of thy glory, to make intercession that I love your mother and all the saints. O most holy Lady, therefore, most light of my darkened soul, my hope, protection, refuge, consolation, my joy, I thank thee that thou art saved me, who am unworthy to be a partaker of the most pure body and precious blood of thy Son. O thou who givest birth to the true life, do thou enlighten me and spiritualize my heart. Thou who givest birth to the source of mortality and revive me, who is dead in sin. Thou most lovingly compassionate mother of the merciful God, have mercy upon me, grant me compunction and restriction in my heart, and humility in my thoughts, and recall my thoughts with captivity, and abstain me from my last breath to receive that formation of sanctification of the most pure mysteries of the human soul and body, and grant me tears of repentance and confession, that I may hid thee and glorify thee all the days of my life. For blessed art thou, and most glorified art thou, O Jesus. Amen. Now let thou thy servant depart from me, so master according to thy words, for mine eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all peoples, a light of revelation to the Gentiles, and the glory of thy people Israel. Holy God, 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 holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Amen. Great,
Of our holy mother, and of all the Lord, the saints, and merciful, save us, we live above God.